I found this spot in the dark last night. I was pretty stoked. I have never stayed in this area and it was after dark. I really don't like driving after dark, but I saw this like road was kind of sus, so I pulled over. I looked at it on Google Maps and it said forestry roads. So, like, oh yeah. I can see this like opening here next to the lake on the satellite image. And then I pull in. There's an outhouse. Oh yeah. I think it's like a boat launch or something, but I had no problem spending the night and it was super quiet. Now there's a bit of industrial traffic, but we're off on our way to the next town to look for Wi-Fi to upload a video. Hey bud, you want to go for a walk? That looks like a yes. Is that a yes? Is that a yes for a walkies? This is so incredible. I did not expect this today. When I left town, I chose this hike from all trails because it was on my route and also because it's a nice distance and pretty flat for Frank. So I thought he'd be excited to get out for a walk. He is very excited to get out for a walk. He loves the snow and I kind of do too. I always forget that I like the snow in winter. And I'm always so sad when summer ends. And then I'm like, oh, well, fall is really nice. And then I'm kind of sad when autumn is ending. But then as soon as there's snow, oh, it's just so gorgeous. It's just magic and it sparkles in the sun. I love it so much. You're welcome. We can hang out in the snow all winter, bud. Yeah. You want to go home? Are you done walking? Yeah, let's go home. Yeah. Precious boy. Good morning. I'm on the edge of civilization. That way there's like a vast expanse of wilderness, and just like a block or two that way starts sprawling suburbia and populated area for what will take hours to drive through. So I'm going in to meet a friend to spend this weekend with her. So I stayed right on the edge. I don't know if I'm allowed to stay here. There's no signs. There's probably not many people that ever stay here, so there wouldn't be a reason to have a sign telling us not to. But that's why my van is running. So I just woke up, just like grinding for coffee, but I just turned my van on so that the engine's warm and the windows are defogged in case somebody stops by and is like, excuse me, no. I can be like, oh, I just got here. See, the engine's warm. So I have the heater going, so it's toasty in here and I can see it. It's very nice. Last night I just hung out super low key in here. It's just like one really dim light on instead of like the string light, so anyone driving by wouldn't see lights. But probably only like a half dozen people drove by anyways. It was really quiet night. It was so nice. So yeah. I'm excited to go see my friend. So I'm just chilling here at the end of the pavement, waiting for my friend to meet me. We just spent the morning at her place. She made me awesome breakfast. I had a really good time starting to catch up. And she just had to make a stop on her way here. And then I'm going to follow her down this dirt road to the end of the lake to spend the afternoon and evening. I will follow you. Yeah, let's roll. I was just winding up my window and I just snapped the handle right off. So it's a good thing I just bought one for Frank's window. I'll use it until I can get another one. But yeah, it just...
Slow down while you're going down the, okay. The step part.
Yeah, I can't see anything.
Is it better if I move to the side? Don't you like just slowing down the roots around here? Okay. Can we just step?
Hi. Move. Oh, good boy.
We're doing quite a sweat for the staff. I've not carried a canoe in years, but I bootied, ground scored this sweet Mora knife, so. Yeah, treasure.
I've just done it once this year, and I'm like, oh yeah, I'm ready.
Yeah, now that I have heat in my van, I'm ready to do it through winter,
yeah,
too.
Yeah,
dude, yeah,
it's so
yeah,
good
we'll
you.
Do it.
God, fine.
Okay, so there's organic roasted dandelion, green tea passion fruit matcha, mango passion fruit, jasmine, lavender, ginger, black tea pomegranate, another ginger, and decaf chai.
I love that.
I think I'm gonna have the same.
Okay, so now I will hold the back, no Zeus, and okay. Then just step in.
Okay.
And then you kind of hold the sides and kind of just crawl to the front. No, Zeus. No, stay. No. And then...
Oh, yeah. We brought life jackets. Thank you.
Yeah, buddy. And then I'm just going to shove it out. So just kind of be prepared for it to be noses. Okay. And then I'm going to push off.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
I think we get this roaring, boil the tea, and while it steeps,
do a cold dip.
Yeah.
I'm down.
I'm just on my way to my first appointment in the city. I'm in North Vancouver and I had to park a kilometer away to be able to easily park my van, not pay parking fees, and trust to a fairly reasonable degree that I will be able to get out of the spot even if somebody parks in front of me. So it's just I avoid coming in here at all costs, but specialist appointments like this one, there's really no way around. And I've been waiting to see an immunologist for a long time. So I'm just chilling in my van. I'm in North Vancouver at a park. It's raining. So it was really easy to park here. There was no one in the parking lot when I got here. I'm like off at the edge. No one can park next to me where I'm parked. So I know I'll be able to get out even if it gets like busy after work and stuff, but my immunologist appointment went better than the last time I saw one. He was a very good listener, which is really important to me in a doctor, that they are curious and ask you questions and like want to hear what your experience has been like, but instead of just like jumping to conclusions or making assumptions. So he did a bunch of allergy testing because I had like had general testing. And one of them that came up was trees. Well, that's a bit of an issue, especially if I don't know what trees, and I had some suspicions, but he confirmed I am very allergic to birch, alder, and oak. I was pretty sure alder and related was part of it, but yeah, so I should avoid those at all costs when they're pollinating. Like extremely allergic to them, and yeah. Sometimes in the spring, like, it's really hard to exist. I'm also allergic to cats, which I can avoid, although I was kind of been wanting to get a van cat, so that's not gonna happen. And cockroaches, which is fine. I have no association with cockroaches, and dust mite. I have respiratory testing tomorrow, late afternoon. So I'm in the city tonight and all day tomorrow. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but right now I'm gonna eat this half a watermelon I'm so excited about. Hi, we're in the city, Frank. There's a lot of smells, bud. So we just got back from a little walk. It's like 8:30 and I think I'm gonna spend the night here. I couldn't find any signs that say no overnight parking or no camping in the park. And I checked on the website for the park's bylaw and couldn't find anything that said I can't be here. So I'm just gonna hope that nobody comes to move me along because it is way quieter than being on the road. Too bad. I slept really well last night for being in the city. There's just like a mild like hum in the distance of traffic and stuff, but nobody like drove in here and nobody bothered us. I just left one of my front windows, like the angled ones, cracked, so it hardly condensed up there. It's something I'm figuring out. Like, I just never thought to leave it open, but I had it cracked at my friend's house and it was windy enough that it didn't condense up there with me heating it back here. So that's awesome. It's like 8 degrees right now. I don't even feel like I need to turn the heat on. I'm super comfortable. I have no desire to go try to do city things or to like go find food or anything. I'm gonna eat fruit and veggies and yeah, it's like stay away from people and everything that's trying to get my attention and trying to get me to spend money and just like block all that out. Just put on horse blinders and yeah, just like take it easy. Yeah. Going for a walk in a city park, eh? Not something we do very often. It's pretty nice though. So I don't think I could have done any better choosing a place to stay last night. And I really don't know the area at all, but just worked out pretty well. Mostly because I wanted to look after Frank well. So I chose somewhere to take him for a walk, which ended up being a good place to stay. We had a nice quiet night and no one bothered us. And now we're out for a morning walk. My van is right next to the trailhead, so I got to just get out of the van and come into the woods. So even though I can still hear civilization all around, children screaming and cars and all that, power tools and stuff, but it's still better than being in the thick of it with only urban noises. So there's a nice creek down there that we're listening to as we walk. And I'm way overdressed. I forgot how warm the coast is. Not interested in you, Frank. So if you've ever wondered, does Amanda ever like get sick of van life and think about moving into the city or something? The answer is no, definitely not. Never, I would never do that to myself. It took me an hour and a half to drive less than 30 kilometers. That's like 20 miles from North Van to Surrey. But I'm here parked outside Canada Engines where I got my engine from. And tomorrow, bright and early, 7:30 in the morning, they're gonna be taking truck and fixing it. Hopefully, I really, really hope that it's gonna be fixed. Well, yeah, that would have been nice if that worked out, but as you will see in the next episode, it's kind of amazing and almost a little unbelievable just how much can go wrong in just a few days. So yeah, that's it for this episode. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe down below if you haven't already. I appreciate you watching so much. I have a cute clip of Frank to send you off on your way. I hope you have a great day and we'll see you soon. Bye.